Laudator Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ, and welcome to Vatican Radio's live-streamed broadcast of Pope Francis' general audience this morning, Wednesday, June 12th, 2024. You have been hearing the members of the Royal Irish Regiment and of the 38th Irish Brigade, and the Pipers, a little Irish bagpipe music there to begin this audience this morning. My name is Christopher Wells. I'll be providing the English language commentary for this morning's audience. And as we begin our broadcast, I would like to extend a warm welcome to everyone joining us through the various Vatican media channels, the Vatican audio or radio app, the Vatican News web portal or YouTube channel, or via one of our partner stations, including EWTN TV, Catholic Faith Network in America, Salt and Light TV out of Canada, Radio Maria England, Shalom World TV, Atmadarshan TV, Catholic TV, Luminous Radio India, and Radio Maria Papua New Guinea. Welcome one and all. As the Holy Father approaches the platform in front of St. Peter's Basilica on a sunny, hot Roman morning, our Holy Father this morning will be continuing his catechesis on the Spirit and the Bride. The Holy Spirit guides the people of God towards Jesus, our hope. This week, the Holy Father is reflecting on the inspiration of sacred scripture by the Holy Spirit, the work of the Holy Spirit in Revelation. If this is your first time tuning into a papal audience, the structure of the audience: the Holy Father will begin with the sign of the cross and the liturgical greeting, peace be with you, followed by a reading from sacred scripture, which this morning will be taken from the second letter of St. Peter. Chapter 1, verses 20 and 21. And after the Pope's greeting, we'll hear the proclamation of that scripture in various languages: French, English, German, Spanish, Portuguese, Arabic, and Polish, as well, of course, as Italian. The Holy Father then gives his catechesis, and afterwards we'll hear a summary of the catechesis in those languages, as well as an exchange of greetings between the Holy Father and the various language groups. And as the audience begins, we prepare ourselves to receive the Holy Father's teaching and his blessing at the end of the audience.
Nel nome del Padre, del Figlio, dello Spirito Santo. La pace sia con voi.
Dalla seconda lettera di San Pietro Apostolo. Fratelli, sappiate anzitutto questo: nessuna scrittura profetica va soggetta a privata spiegazione, poiché non da volontà umana è mai venuta una profezia, ma mossi da Spirito Santo parlarono alcuni uomini da parte di Dio. Parola di Dio.
De la deuxième lettre de Saint Pierre apôtre. Frères, vous savez cette chose primordiale: pour aucune prophétie de l'Écriture il ne peut y avoir d'interprétation individuelle. puisque ce n'est jamais par la volonté d'un homme qu'un message prophétique a été porté. C'est porté par l'Esprit Saint que des hommes ont parlé de la part de Dieu. Parole du Seigneur.
From the second letter of Saint Peter. Brothers and sisters, first of all, you must understand this, that no prophecy of Scripture is a matter of one's own interpretation, because no prophecy ever came by human will, but men and women, moved by the Holy Spirit, spoke from God. The Word of the Lord.
Lesung aus dem zweiten Petrusbrief. Brüder und Schwestern, bedenkt dabei vor allem dies. Keine Prophezie der Schrift wird durch eigenmächtige Auslegung wirksam, denn niemals wurde eine Prophezie durch den Willen eines Menschen hervorgebracht, sondern vom Heiligen Geist getrieben, haben Menschen im Auftrag Gottes geredet. Wort des lebendigen Gottes.
Lectura de la segunda carta de Pedro. Hermanos, tengan presente ante todo que nadie puede interpretar por cuenta propia una profecía de la Escritura, porque ninguna profecía ha sido anunciada por voluntad humana, sino que los hombres han hablado de parte de Dios, impulsados por el Espíritu Santo. Palabra de Dios.
Leitura da segunda carta de São Pedro. Irmãos, antes de tudo, tende presente que ninguém pode interpretar por si mesmo uma profecia da Escritura, porque jamais uma profecia foi proferida pela vontade de um homem, mas, sendo movidos pelo Espírito Santo, é que certos homens falaram da parte de Deus. Palavra do Senhor.
قراءة من رسالة القديس بطرس الرسول الثانية أيها الإخوة أعلموا قبل كل شيء أنه ما من نبوءة في الكتاب تقبل تفسيراً يأتي به أحد من عنده إذ لم تأتي نبوءة قط بإرادة بشر ولكن الروح القدس حمل بعض الناس على أن يتكلموا من قبل الله كلام الرب
Czytanie z drugiego listu świętego Piotra Apostoła. Bracia, to przede wszystkim miejcie na uwadze, że żadne proroctwo Pisma nie jest dla prywatnego wyjaśniania. Nie z woli bowiem ludzkiej zostało kiedyś przyniesione proroctwo, ale kierowani Duchem Świętym mówili od Boga święci ludzie. Oto Słowo Boże.
And with the conclusion of the reading from Scripture, we'll now hear the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning and welcome.
Proseguiamo la catechesi.
Let us continue the catechesis on the Holy Spirit, who guides the Church towards Christ our hope. He is the guide. Last time we contemplated the work of the Spirit in creation. Today we will see it in Revelation, in which the Sacred Scriptures is a witness inspired by God, is also authoritative. The second letter of Paul to Timothy contains this statement. All Scripture is inspired by God. And another passage in the New Testament says, men moved by the Holy Spirit spoke from God. This is the doctrine of the divine inspiration of the Scriptures. That which we proclaim as an article of faith in the Creed, when we say that the Holy Spirit has spoken through the prophets, the divine inspiration of the Bible. The Holy Spirit, inspired the Scriptures, is also He who explains and makes them perennially living and active. From inspired, He makes them inspiring. The Sacred Scriptures, as inspired by God, according to the Second Vatican Council, and committed once for all to writing, impart the Word of God Himself without change, and make the voice of the Holy Spirit resound in the words of the prophets and apostles. In this way, the Holy Spirit continues in the Church the action of Christ, the Risen One, who after Easter opened their minds to understand, to the understanding of Scriptures. Indeed, it can happen that in a certain passage of the Scripture that we have read many times without any particular emotion, one day we might read it in an atmosphere of faith and prayer, and then that text is unexpectedly illuminated. It speaks to us. It sheds light on a problem we are living. It makes God's will for us clear in certain situations. To what does this change do, if not to an enlightenment of the Holy Spirit? The words of Scripture, under the action of the Spirit, become luminous. And in those cases, we touch with our own hands the truth of the statement in the letter of the Hebrews. The Word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword. Brothers and sisters, the Church is nourished by the spiritual reading of the Sacred Scripture. That is, by reading under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, who inspired it. At its heart, like a beacon that illuminates everything, there is the event of the death and resurrection of Christ, which accomplishes the plan of salvation, realizes all the figures in the prophecies, and unveils the hidden mysteries, and offers the true key to reading the entire Bible. The death and resurrection of Jesus is the beacon that enlightens all of the Bible and of our life. Revelation describes all of this with the image of the Lamb that breaks the seal of the book written within and on the back, sealed with seven seals. The Scripture of the Old Testament. The Church, the Bride of Christ, is the authorized interpreter of the inspired text. The Church is the mediator of its authentic proclamation. Since the Church is gifted with the Holy Spirit, for this reason, she is inspired by the Spirit. She is the pillar and bulwark of the truth. It's the task of the Church to help the faithful and those who seek the truth to interpret it, to interpret the biblical texts correctly. One way of doing spiritual reading of the Word of God is the practice of what is called the Lectio Divina. It consists in dedicating a certain time each day to the personal and meditative reading of a passage of the Scripture. And this is very important. Every day, take a little time to listen, to meditate, read a passage from Scripture. And for this reason, I recommend that you always have a copy of the Bible in your purse or in your pocket. And then when you're on a journey, you can just take your little book and read from it. This is very important for life. Take a pocket copy of the New Testament, of the Gospels, and take the opportunity to read it throughout the day. But the quintessential spiritual reading in Scripture is the community reading done in the liturgy, and in particular in the Holy Mass. There we see how an event or teaching given by the Old Testament finds its full expression in the Gospel of Christ. The homily must help to transfer the Word of God. The homily by the celebrant must help to transfer the Word of God from the book to life. But the homily should be short. One image, one sentiment, one image, one thought. And it shouldn't go beyond 8 minutes. Because after that, you lose people's attention. And the people fall asleep. And they're right. A homily should be like this. And that earns him a round of applause. And sometimes, you know, priests say, if they're too long, people don't understand anything. So keep them short. One thought, one sentiment. And one thought of what you should do about it. Not more than 8 minutes. So again, the homily should help us to transfer the Word of God from the book to our own lives. One of the many words of God that we hear every day at Mass or in the Liturgy of the Hours, there's always one that's meant specially for us, that touches our heart. And welcomed into the heart, it can illuminate our day and inspire our prayer. It's a question of not letting it fall on deaf ears. Let's conclude with a thought that can help us to fall in love with the Word of God. Like certain pieces of music, the Sacred Scripture too has a fundamental note that accompanies it from the beginning to the end. And this note is the love of God. The whole Bible, St. Augustine says, does nothing other but tell of God's love. And St. Gregory the Great defines the Scripture as a letter from God Almighty to his creature. Like a letter from a bridegroom to his bride. It exhorts us to learn and know the heart of God in the words of God. Through this revelation, again, Vatican II, the invisible God, out of the abundance of his love, speaks to humans as friends and lives among them, so that he might invite them and take them into fellowship with himself. Dear brothers and sisters, let's go forward with the reading of the Bible. So don't forget your pocket Bible in your purse, in your pocket, and at different moments during the day, read a passage. to make the Holy Spirit close to us in the Word of God. The Holy Spirit, may the Holy Spirit, who inspired the Scriptures and now breathes from them, help us to grasp this love of God in the concrete situations of our life. Thank you. And now we have the exchange of greetings in the different languages. The speaker greets the Holy Father in the name of, in this case, French speakers. Then there's a word of explanation of the remainder of the audience for people who speak French or the different languages. Our speaker in a moment will give us a summary of the catechesis we've just heard in their own language. And afterwards, the Holy Father will say a few words in Italian, directed especially to those people who speak those languages. The initial exchange of greetings and the summary are essentially the same in each language, so I won't be translating those for you. However, after the Holy Father's greeting in Italian, as the speakers are translating into their own language, I'll also be translating into English. So currently, the first language we hear each week after Italian is French.
L'Église épouse du Christ est l'interprète autorisée des textes inspirés et la médiatrice de leur proclamation authentique. Elle se nourrit des Écritures à la lumière de la mort et la résurrection de Jésus, sous l'action de l'Esprit-Saint qui lui ouvre l'intelligence. Saint Augustin nous dit que toute la Bible ne fait que nous dire l'amour de Dieu. Goûtons la lecture spirituelle de l'Écriture sainte, particulièrement dans la liturgie de la messe ou dans la Lectio Divina. L'Esprit qui a inspiré ces paroles les rendra inspirantes pour accueillir l'amour de Dieu dans le concret de nos vies. Maintenant, le Saint-Père va saluer en italien les fidèles de langue française.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini di lingua francese venuti da Parigi e da Lucan. In particolare i giovani giunti dalle istituzioni scolastiche di Francia. Imploriamo lo Spirito Santo di aprire la nostra mente all'intelligenza delle Scritture affinché possiamo contemplare il volto di Gesù risorto e illuminare il nostro agire nel mondo. Dio vi benedica.
Vous saluant en italien, le Saint-Père vient de dire. Je salue cordialement les
pèlerins. I cordially greet the French-speaking pilgrims who have come from Paris and Luçon, especially the young people who have come from the educational institutions of France. We implore the Holy Spirit to open our minds to the understanding of the Scriptures so we may contemplate the face of the risen Jesus and illuminate our actions in the world. May God bless you. And now we'll hear the exchange of greetings in English.
Most Holy Father, the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors wish to express to you their sentiments of deep respect and esteem, and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Peter. At the end of the audience, we will sing together the Our Father in Latin. His Holiness will then impart his apostolic blessing, which he extends in a particular way to the members of your families at home. He also intends to bless any religious articles you may have brought for this purpose. And in a special way, his blessing goes to your children, the elderly, and those who are sick. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's catechesis at the beginning of the audience. Today, in our continuing catechesis on the Holy Spirit and the Bride, we reflect on the action of the Holy Spirit in divine revelation, specifically in sacred scripture. God, who inspired scripture, in turn inspires the church, the bride of Christ, through his holy word, making of her its authoritative interpreter. The Spirit also communicates with us personally within this ecclesial reality, whether through Lectio Divina, which is a meditative reading of a scripture passage, or above all, in the liturgy. In whatever setting, there is always one word that is meant especially for us. Like a musical composition, sacred scripture carries throughout an underlying theme, which St. Augustine and St. Gregory the Great call God's love. May we learn to know the heart of God through the words of God and allow them to breathe that love into our daily lives. The Holy Father will now greet us in Italian.
Do un cordiale benvenuto a tutti i pellegrini della lingua inglese presenti all'odierna udienza, specialmente ai gruppi provenienti dal Regno Unito, Cina, India, Indonesia, le Filippine e gli Stati Uniti. Invoco su tutti voi la gioia e la pace di nostro Signore Gesù Cristo. Dio vi benedica.
I extend a cordial welcome to the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors taking part in today's audience, especially the groups from the United Kingdom, China, India, Indonesia, the Philippines, and the United States of America. I invoke upon you and your families the joy and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you.
And following the English, we'll hear the exchange of greetings in German.
Heiliger Vater, die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache möchten Ihnen ihre herzliche Zuneigung und aufrichtige Verbundenheit bekunden und versichern Sie zugleich Ihres Gebets in allen Anliegen Ihres universalen apostolischen Dienstes. Zum Schluss dieser Audienz singen wir gemeinsam das Vater Unser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin Ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kinder, die älteren Menschen und die Leidenden. Er segnet auch die Rosenkränze und die übrigen Andachtsgegenstände, die Sie dafür mitgebracht haben. Es folgt nun eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, heute befassen wir uns mit dem Wirken des Heiligen Geistes in der göttlichen Offenbarung. Von ihm bekennen wir im Credo, der gesprochen hat durch die Propheten. Der Heilige Geist ist also der Urheber der Heiligen Schrift. Jede Schrift ist von Gott eingegeben. Das Zweite Vatikanische Konzil erklärt diese Lehre von der göttlichen Inspiration der biblischen Bücher näher. Es sagt, dass sie von Gott eingegeben und ein für alle Male niedergeschrieben, das Wort Gottes selbst unwandelbar vermitteln und in den Worten der Propheten und der Apostel die Stimme des Heiligen Geistes vernehmen lassen. In diesem Sinne kann die Heilige Schrift nach den Worten des heiligen Gregors des Großen als ein Brief des allmächtigen Gottes an sein Geschöpf verstanden werden, um uns Menschen zur Gemeinschaft mit ihm einzuladen. Der Heilige Vater richtet nun einen kurzen Gruß auf Italienisch an die deutschsprachigen Gläubigen.
Rivolgo un cordiale saluto ai pellegrini di lingua tedesca. Leggiamo e meditiamo la scrittura, chiedendo la luce dello Spirito Santo per poter conoscere sempre meglio Cristo e annunciarlo con la testimonianza della nostra vita.
Einen herzlichen Gruß richte ich an die Pilger deutscher Sprache. Lesen und betrachten wir die Heilige Schrift.
I extend a cordial greeting to the German-speaking pilgrims. Let us read and meditate on sacred scripture, asking for the light of the Holy Spirit, so we may always know Christ better and proclaim him with the witness of our lives. For the exchange of greetings in Spanish, the Holy Father will give the summary himself, the summary of the catechesis, since Spanish is his first language, his mother tongue. Once again, we won't be translating the summary. It's very similar to the one that we just heard in English. However, at the conclusion of the Holy Father's words, he will say a few words, especially for Spanish speakers, and I will be offering a translation of that.
La bendición apostólica que extiende complacido a sus familiares, especialmente a los niños y a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren. Bendice también los rosarios y objetos de devoción que los peregrinos llevan consigo.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, continuamos con nuestra catequesis sobre el Espíritu Santo y hoy destacamos su acción de inspirar. En el credo decimos que es Él quien habló a través de los profetas. El documento conciliar Dei Verbum añade que nos habla también a través de las palabras de los apóstoles, contenidas en la Sagrada Escritura. Él es quien ha inspirado a los autores sagrados de la Biblia, por lo que reconocemos que esta es palabra de Dios. Él es quien nos la explica, haciéndola viva y eficaz. El Espíritu Santo se encarga de seguir nutriendo a la Iglesia con la palabra divina, porque es bajo su guía que nosotros podemos leerla, meditarla, llevarla a nuestra propia vida. Y esto sucede cada vez que tomamos un fragmento de la Sagrada Escritura para tener un momento de oración. Pero particularmente cuando la proclamamos en la Eucaristía, donde constatamos cómo una enseñanza del Antiguo Testamento encuentra su plenitud en el Evangelio de Cristo. Saludo cordialmente a los peregrinos de lengua española.
I warmly greet these Spanish-speaking pilgrims. Let's ask the Holy Spirit to enlighten our whole life with His Word, so we may bear witness to Christ. May Jesus bless you and the Holy Virgin watch over you. Thank you. And now the exchange of greetings in Portuguese.
Santo Padre, os fiéis de língua portuguesa desejam testemunhar-lhe filial afeto e sincera fidelidade, e rezam por todas as intenções do seu ministério apostólico universal. No final desta audiência, cantaremos a oração do Pai Nosso em latim. Depois, o Santo Padre concederá a bênção apostólica com um pensamento especial às crianças, aos idosos e aos doentes. Abençoará também os terços e demais objetos de devoção que cada um tiver consigo. Leio agora um resumo da catequese que o Santo Padre acaba de pronunciar.
Continuamos as catequeses sobre o Espírito Santo. No Credo, dizemos que ele falou por meio dos profetas. De fato, a ele se deve a inspiração divina das Escrituras. E não só as inspirou, como abre o entendimento de cada um de nós para as compreender. Graças a ele, as palavras da Bíblia iluminam os problemas que enfrentamos, tornando clara a vontade de Deus a nosso respeito. Por isso, todo aquele que, na casa da igreja, lê as Escrituras guiado pelo Espírito Santo, alimenta-se espiritualmente. Muitos fiéis têm o hábito de se dedicarem à meditação pessoal da Bíblia, na chamada Lectio Divina. Porém, não esqueçamos que a leitura espiritual, por excelência, acontece na Eucaristia, quando, em comunidade, é proclamado o grande amor de Deus por nós. Agora, o Santo Padre saúda em italiano os fiéis de língua portuguesa.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini di lingua portoghese, particolare quelli provenienti dal Portogallo e dal Brasile. Domani celebreremo Sant'Antonio, nato a Lisbona, che ci dice se leggi Gesù, egli ti sazia la mente. Incoraggio dunque ognuno di voi a meditare la Sacra Scrittura. In essa Gesù ci rinvigorisce e illumina la nostra vita. Dio vi benedica.
Eis a tradução das suas palavras.
I warmly greet the Portuguese-speaking pilgrims, especially those from Portugal and Brazil. Tomorrow we will celebrate Saint Anthony, who was born in Lisbon, and who tells us, if you read Jesus, he will fill your mind. I encourage each of you, therefore, to meditate on Sacred Scripture. In it, Jesus invigorates us and enlightens our lives. May God bless you. The greetings in Portuguese are followed by an exchange of greetings in Arabic.
أيها الأب الأقدس يسر المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية الحاضرين هنا أن يعبروا لكم عن مشاعر الاحترام والتقدير وشكرهم البنوي ويرفقونها بصلواتهم الدائمة إلى الله من أجل قداستكم وخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنرتل معا صلاة الأبان باللغة اللاتينية ثم سيمنح الأب الأقدس جميع الحاضرين البركة الرسولية ويشمل بها جميع أحبائكم وخاصة الأطفال والمتزوجين حديثاً والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين بآلام شديدة وسيبارك كذلك المسابح والأشياء الطقوية التي يحملها معه كل واحد منكم إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس تكلم قداسة البابا اليوم على الروح القدس الذي يقود شعب الله إلى لقاء يسوع موضوع رجائنا وقال الروح القدس هو الذي ألهم الكتب المقدسة فكل ما كتب هو من وحي الله وكتبت الكتب المقدسة مرة واحدة بصورة نهائية لتبلغ دون تغيير كلمة الله نفسها وتجعل صوت الروح القدس يدوي في أقوال الأنبياء والرسل بهذه الطريقة الروح القدس يواصل في الكنيسة عمل الرب القائم من بين الأموات الذي فتح بعض الفصح أذهان تلاميذه ليفهموا الكتب والكنيسة هي المفسر صاحب الصلاحية للنص الموحى به وقال قداسته القراءة الربانية تساعدنا لنقرأ كلمة الله قراءة روحية إنها تقوم بتخصيص بعض الوقت في أثناء النهار لقراءة مقطع من الكتاب المقدس قراءة شخصية وبتأمل. والقراءة الروحية بامتياز للكتاب المقدس هي القراءة الجماعية التي نقوم بها في الليتورجية وخاصة في القداس الإلهي، لأنها تبين لنا كيف يتحقق العهد القديم بالعهد الجديد، وكيف علينا أن نعيش كلمة الله في حياتنا. يقول القديس أغسطينوس إن الكتاب المقدس كله يروي فقط محبة الله والروح القدس. الذي ألهم الكتاب المقدس يساعدنا لنفهم محبة الله لنا في المواقف العملية في حياتنا. والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين اللغة العربية.
Saluto i fedeli di lingua araba. Lo Spirito Santo che ci ha ispirato le scritture ci aiuti a cogliere l'amore di Dio nelle situazioni concrete della nostra vita. Signore, vi benedica e vi protegga sempre da ogni male.
I greet the Arabic-speaking faithful. May the Holy Spirit, who inspired these scriptures, help us to grasp God's love in the concrete situations of our lives. May the Lord bless you all and protect you always from all evil. And now the exchange of greetings in Polish.
Ojcze Święty, pielgrzymi z Polski i z innych krajów pragną przekazać Waszej świątobliwości wyrazy synowskiego oddania i szczerej wierności, zapewniając o modlitwie we wszystkich intencjach Jego apostolskiej posługi. Na zakończenie audiencji zaśpiewamy modlitwę Ojcze Nasz po łacinie. Po jej zakończeniu Ojciec Święty udzieli nam apostolskiego błogosławieństwa, obejmując nim szczególnie dzieci, osoby w podeszłym wieku i dotknięte cierpieniem. Pobłogosławi także różańce i dewocjonalia, jakie pielgrzymi przynoszą ze sobą. A oto streszczenie katechezy Ojca Świętego. Drodzy bracia i siostry, kontynuujemy katechezę o Duchu Świętym. Dziś rozważamy działanie Ducha w objawieniu, którego Pismo Święte jest świadectwem natchnionym przez Boga i wiarygodnym. Święty Paweł stwierdza, że wszelkie Pismo jest natchnione od Boga. Zaś Święty Piotr mówi, kierowani Duchem Świętym mówili od Boga święci ludzie. W centrum Pisma Świętego znajduje się wydarzenie śmierci i zmartwychwstania Chrystusa. Ono wypełnia plan zbawienia, odsłania ukryte tajemnice i daje klucz do odczytania Biblii. Kościół jest uprawnionym interpretatorem tekstu natchnionego. Jednym ze sposobów czytania duchowego Słowa Bożego jest praktyka Lectio Divina, ale duchowe czytanie Pisma Świętego jest par excellence czytaniem wspólnotowym, które odbywa się w liturgii, zwłaszcza podczas mszy świętej i liturgii godzin. Pismo Święte jest według świętego Grzegorza Wielkiego listem Boga do swojego stworzenia. Obyśmy nauczyli się poznawać serce Boga ze słów Bożych. Niech to słowo rzuca światło na nasz problem, czyniąc jasną wolę Boga wobec nas. Obecnie Ojciec Święty pozdrowi nas, Polaków, w języku włoskim.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini polacchi. La vostra patria da secoli cristiana è chiamata Polonia semper fidelis. Tuttavia, perseverare nella fedeltà a Cristo e alla sua Chiesa non è possibile grazie alle sole forze umane, ma alla forza dello Spirito Santo. Ascoltare la parola di Dio Lasciatevi ispirare da essa per sapere come distinguere la verità dalla falsità, la libertà dalla schiavitù. Siate fedeli a Dio. Polonia semper fidelis. Vi benedico di cuore.
Oto słowa Ojca Świętego. Serdecznie pozdrawiam.
I cordially greet the Polish pilgrims. Your homeland, Christian for centuries, is called Poland Semper Fidelis, always faithful. However, persevering in fidelity to Christ and His Church is not possible by human strength alone, but only by the power of the Holy Spirit. Listen then to the Word of God. Be inspired by it to know how to distinguish truth from falsehood, freedom from slavery. Be faithful to God. Poland Semper Fidelis. And I bless you from my heart.
Polonia semper fidelis. Serce wam błogosławię.
And following the exchange of greetings in Poland, the Holy Father will greet Italian speakers. There's no summary, of course, because the catechesis was delivered in Italian, but he will have a few words for those pilgrims and visitors coming from Italy or otherwise Italian-speaking. And a reminder that after the conclusion of the Italian greetings, the Holy Father will lead us in chanting the Our Father in Latin. Pope Francis will then offer his apostolic blessing, which is extended not only to those present, but also to family and friends, as well as the elderly, the young, and those who are sick. And a reminder, too, that the Holy Father's blessing also goes out to all those listening in live to this broadcast. I extend a cordial greeting to the Italian-speaking pilgrims. In particular, I greet Archbishop Ambrogio Spreafico, with faithful of the Diocese of Frosinone Veroli Frentino, who are celebrating the 1500th anniversary of the death of the Holy Pontiff Ormistus, the patron saint of the city of Frosinone. I also greet the Volley Academy of Piacenza, which is committed to promoting a safe sporting environment, in collaboration with the Diocesan Service for the Protection of Minors, as well as the participants in the Academic, Social, and Label Forum of the Energy Industry, promoted by Scuolas Occorrentes. My thoughts go finally to the young, the sick, the elderly, and to newlyweds. Tomorrow we will celebrate the liturgical memory of St. Anthony of Padua, priest and doctor of the Church. May the example of this distinguished preacher, protector of the poor and of the suffering, awaken in everyone the desire to pursue the path of faith and imitate his life, thus become incredible witnesses of the gospel. And let us not forget tormented Ukraine. Let us not forget Palestine, Israel. Let us not forget Myanmar and so many countries that are at war. Let us pray for peace. Today we want peace. Let's pray for peace. That the Lord will give strength to always fight for peace. And my blessing to all of you. And now we'll have the Our Father and the blessing.
Pater noster qui es in celis, sanctificetur voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in temptationem, sed libera nos a malo.
Dominum vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui feci caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, Filius, Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen.
And with the Holy Father's apostolic blessing, this morning's general audience draws to a close. On behalf of Vatican Radio, I would like to thank our partners who help make these live broadcasts available throughout the world, including EWTN-TV, Catholic Faith Network in America, Salt and Light TV, Radio Maria England, Shalom World TV, Atmadarshan TV, Catholic TV, Luminous Radio in India, and Radio Maria, Papua New Guinea. Thanks, too, to our producers and technicians here in studio. And thanks to all of you for joining us today. For full coverage of today's audience, as well as other news from the Vatican and around the world, we invite you to visit the Vatican News web portal, as well as our Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube accounts. I'm Christopher Wells. It's been a great pleasure providing coverage of today's general audience. Christ is risen. Praise be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.